express on the Edge are not necessarily those of this radio station, its staff, management, or other sponsors. It's time for the Edge Radio broadcast with your host, Daniel Ott. You can join Daniel and his guest as we discover the truth together. Within the continental U.S., call toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or click on the Fast Blast link on the Edge Broadcast website. That's toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or click on the Fast Blast link on the Edge Broadcast website. You can find out more about our guests and topics by logging onto the Edge's website at theedgeam.com. That's theedgeam.com. And now, here's your host for the Edge Radio broadcast. Here's Daniel Ott.
And welcome back to the Edge television broadcast. My name is Daniel Ott. Thank you, everyone, so much for joining the program. Getting ready to shift to our newsmaker line to get David Eells on the program. You still have a couple of minutes to tell your friends you've got to tune in to the Edge television broadcast. Enlightening, entertaining, or controversial. Maybe all three tonight, maybe one or the other. Whoa, just hit that mic, my bad. Hey, by the way, as far as a lot of the emails, the ones got rather lengthy, and as I said before, if you send in the lengthy ones, it's 3 or 4 pages, I may not have time, so you want to get what you have to say, please get it in the first paragraph or so. A lot of you took the time to write extensive comments about last week's program, and I do appreciate it, but I tell you, my time is very limited, so please stay to the stick to the point when you do that. Now let's go to our newsmaker line and see if we have with us David Eells. David, are you with us?
Yes, I am. God bless you.
All right, Mr. Eells, thank you for coming on the program tonight. As I was telling everyone, of course, last week we had Matthew Stevens on, and your name was mentioned, and certainly this is an equal opportunity program, and I just wanted to give you the chance to maybe make some clarifications and address some of the comments that were made last week. But before we do, David, for those new listeners who'd like to know a little bit about you, if you could just give us a brief synopsis of who you are, what you do, and then we'll just go from there.
Well, we are a ministry in Pensacola, Florida, Unleavened Bread Ministries. Our site is unleavenedbreadministries.org. Also known as americaslastdays.com. And we do a similar thing with you. We do a internet broadcast, radio broadcast, a satellite broadcast, and so on. And we all have a local, small local assembly, but our biggest ministry is to people out in the world. So
okay.
We try very hard to be scriptural in what we do. We are seeking to go back to the way it was with the apostles and to be obedient to everything that we see in the scriptures.
Okay. Well, it sounds like a very valid thing you're doing there, and certainly probably well needed. I think there's a lot of misdirection out there, and hopefully the way you present it is different than others that may have preceded you, because I think a lot of people maybe would listen to, say, particular messages if they were just presented in a right way, without the hypocrisy with it. So, okay, Mr. Eells, why don't we talk about that last week? I don't expect that you would have caught the program. Just suffice it to say, I know by talking with you that you received a lot of email regarding that interview. I certainly received tons of it. And I would even think that Matthew received some in his own right there. I guess to begin, we'd want to know how you got involved, or Matthew got involved with your organization or association there, and what happened to it.
Okay, well, we had heard from quite a few people that Matthew had somewhat of agreement with us as far as what he saw concerning the things that were coming upon the United States, and so I'd called him. In fact, they were recommending that we have him on our program. So I called him and, you know, asked a few questions about the things he was seeing, and they indeed were similar. Right. And so we invited him to come and make a program with us. Right. And it was kind of a strange thing because we, before he even got here, on his way here, one of our elders, we were a five-fold ministry, and to us, elders are five-fold ministers, apostles, prophets, mm-hmm. pastors, teachers, evangelists. Right. So one of our ministers, Bob Accardi, got a word of knowledge. And for some of you out there probably don't know what a word of knowledge is. Well, it's a word from God concerning things that your mind really doesn't have any way to come into the understanding of. Right. So basically, he got a word of knowledge that Matthew would be like another man who turned out to be false and a slanderer of our ministry. Whoa. We didn't really know how to handle that because we hadn't heard anything bad about him up until this time, but we knew to respect this, and so we just kind of held it close, and we interviewed Matthew a little bit when he came over, and we talked about prophecy, and probably within 10 minutes or so of the beginning to speak with him, he came out with a statement about a lot of women chasing after him, and that he was trying hard to discourage this. We thought it was kind of strange to interject that into our discussion about prophecy, but we went on.
Right.
And we actually had made accommodations for him, and we told him we had accommodations for him at Bob Accardi's house. And Bob, of course, was the only one there. It's a very nice house, very comfortable. And but he told us he didn't want to do that. He said he always went to a hotel. And so I said, are you sure? I mean, everything is perfect here, you know. It won't cost you anything. And no, he was sure. And so we found out later why he indeed demands to go to hotels. And as we go on, you'll probably understand that. But at any rate, we found that he tells everybody this about women chasing after him, and it's kind of a cover. And the evidence that we got right off after Matthew left us was that he was chasing this young sister in our assembly that's young enough to be his daughter. And we did a little research on Matthew, found out he changed his name about three times. He's known as Matthew Stephen, but he's really Matthew Stephen Morinor. And he changed his Stephen, too, because his name used to be Stephen, S-T-E-V-E-N. Hmm. So we got a little suspicious there, but we were getting real suspicious when this sister basically told us the things that she did. We found out that he was basically chasing after her for lustful sexual purposes. Jeez. And we call her T on our spot on the site, on the front page of our site. All the witnesses are there except for the ones that are coming in now. We're still getting people that are witnessing these kind of things about Matthew, and we haven't written them all up. We haven't put them all on there, but on the front page of our site, there is a article there that we couldn't possibly touch tonight with all the evidence and the witnesses that we have. Mm-hmm. So anyway, we discovered this. This girl asked that we leave her name out of it, and it was okay with us because I had interviewed her. Another elder, Rob, had interviewed her, and his wife had interviewed her, and also Pastor Bob from Spirit One Broadcasting had interviewed her. Mm-hmm. And we found her to be truthful in everything that she said. According to other witnesses, we found her to be truthful.